Let's review the reactivity of dienes in acid additions pertaining to kinetic product and thermodynamic product. And so the kinetic product is going to be the fastest product to form due to the proximity effect. So what we're saying by that is that as we add our proton and as we're forming a delta plus on this carbon in a Markovnikov addition, we are saying that a nucleophile that has a minus charge is going to be associating with this position before the bonds completely break, and again this is a transition state effect, and before resonance can develop. Okay, and so the delta plus is not as defined on this carbon as it is on the 2 position. So we're going to always call the kinetic effect the 1-2 product. Okay, and we're approximating this because there's always an example that violates the rule due to sterics or some other, but as far with all other things aside, we're going to call the kinetic product the 1-2 product due to this proximity effect of the delta plus buildup as the nucleophile adds. And the thermodynamic product, on the other hand, is going to be the most stable product regardless of whether it's a 1-2, 1-4 addition. So the most substituted alkene will be the most stable product. And actually, we should say that the kinetic product always arises from the most stable cation, or most stable intermediate. And we'll see what we mean by that in just a moment. Okay, and if we look at the thermodynamic product, it arises from 1-2 or 1-4, and it may arise from a different intermediate than the kinetic product does. Okay, so it's not tied down to any particular addition order, because if there's enough energy in the system, and we give it enough time, so we'll say high temp and low and long reaction time, then we can equilibrate to the most stable product. We can reverse steps, we can form the kinetic, reverse it, then reform, and we'll show that with an energy diagram in a moment. Kinetic product is going to be favored by limiting the energy and not allowing time for reversal in the reaction. Okay, and so let's look at butadiene, the classic example. So we're going to treat this with an acid, and anytime you react the diene, you're going to add the hydrogens to the outside positions, the cation to the inside, because we want to form allylic cation. So we have these two possibilities, and it turns out these are exactly the same, so we'll only have to consider one of them. Okay, so kind of have a look at that and see how these are the same cation. We'll only consider one. Well, we said in a different video that the 1-2 position are where the action occurs, where that initial addition occurs. So we define these 1, 2, 3, 4. Nothing to do with naming, it's just identifying where the reactivity is occurring. And so from this cation, the only possibility, we can form a 1-2 product. Say we have hydrochloric acid, or we can form a 1-4 product. And again, we looked at 1-2 versus 1-4 in a different video. All right, so here's 1-2, 1-4. So we know that this is the kinetic product, favored at low temperature, long reaction time, major product. So thermodynamic product, we have to look and see, well, what's more stable? Well, here, this is a disubstituted double bond, so this is the thermodynamic. And if we look at an energy diagram of this system, we can actually show how the alkene starting material, expends a lot of energy to form the carbocation. And then at this point, we have a favored pathway, and we'll even show it as exergonic, a favored pathway at low temperature, but a more stable product possible overall. Okay, so it's easier to form the kinetic, but it's higher energy. Okay, so the transition state is lower, but it's definitely higher in energy than the thermodynamic product. Okay, so that's how that system would look. The intermediate here, the carbocation is here, and then we see our 1,2 versus 1,4. Starting with our starting material. Okay, as we look at this in terms of an energy diagram.